Hola, soy Brenda
y yo soy Romina.
Somos tus profesoras de español de Hola Spanish.
And today, bienvenidos a un especial de Noche de Brujas de Hola Tuesday.
Today we're going to have a look at some useful expressions in Spanish that we use inspired by the Noche de Brujas, which is Halloween en español. So today we're going to talk about expressions with the word miedo, que significa fear. So, la expresión número uno, we're going to use el verbo tener. So the verb tener, as you know, means to have. So we, in Spanish, say that we possess fear, or something that gives us fear. We say, tengo miedo, okay? Tengo miedo significa I am scared or I am afraid of something.
It's almost like saying, like, I have fear too, sort of.
I am fearful towards something, or I have this fear, okay? So let's go back to the expression is, tengo miedo, okay? I have fear will be the literal translation. Now, when we want to say, well, what are we afraid of, we're going to use the preposición a, okay? Por ejemplo, tengo miedo a, and then the cause of your fear. So, the question that I would like to ask you and that we are going to answer in today's lesson is, ¿a qué tienes miedo? ¿A qué tienes miedo? What are you afraid of? So let's have a look at some examples, some vocabulario that we can use to talk about our fears en español, nuestros miedos. We can say, tengo miedo a, and then you can say what you're afraid of. Por ejemplo, tengo miedo a las arañas. Tengo miedo a los tiburones. We can also use other nouns, like, for example, abstract nouns. Tengo miedo a la oscuridad.
O, por ejemplo, tengo miedo a las alturas.
Exactamente, tengo miedo a las alturas. ¿Qué más? We can also use a verb in the infinitive form. Por ejemplo, tengo miedo a volar. Tengo miedo a manejar o conducir, etc. Muy bien. Tengo miedo a las cucarachas.
De terror.
Okay, so now I'm gonna ask Romy. ¿A qué tienes miedo, Romy?
Yo tengo miedo a las alturas, sinceramente. Sí. Tengo muchísimo miedo a las alturas. ¿Y tú a qué tienes miedo?
Yo también tengo miedo a las alturas y tengo mucho miedo a las arañas.
Muchísimo miedo a las arañas.
Okay, so if you say tengo miedo, that ¿qué significa? I want to hear it. Did you learn the lesson? Tengo miedo significa I am scared. So, I want to ask you now, ¿cómo se dice I am not afraid? Tengo miedo is I am afraid. So, if I want to say I am not scared, I'm going to say no tengo miedo. Okay, what happens if you are a very brave person and you are not afraid of anything, nothing scares you, then you can say no tengo miedo a nada. Okay, no tengo miedo a nada. So that is one of the expressions. In the comments below, before we go to the expression number two, I want you to use this structure that we have just learned, and I want you to answer the question, ¿a qué tienes miedo? If you're not afraid of anything and you are very brave, muy valiente, then you can say, no tengo miedo a nada. But if you are scared, then tell us, what are you afraid of? ¿A qué tienes miedo? If we haven't mentioned the vocabulary here, you can look it up and we'll correct you if you are wrong or if there's anything that needs checking there. Okay, I'm very curious. I really want to know, ¿a qué tienes miedo?
La expresión número dos es con el verbo dar. It's with the verb to give, dar, okay? So we're basically saying something gives me fear, okay? So it's a little bit similar to the verb gustar, to like.
Right, so but in this case we're going to say dar miedo, to give fear. Something gives you fear.
Exactly, yes.
It's quite
similar to the verb gustar. Some of you may know this expression already. Basically, you have to be aware of if it's a singular a singular noun or a plural noun, right? So for example, if you want to say, I like chocolate, right? We are actually in Spanish saying chocolate pleases to me or I likes to me, something like that.
Yeah, something like chocolate interests me or...
Yes, exactly. So it's sort of like chocolate doing the action of liking. So in that case, if you say el chocolate is singular, right? So you have to say me gusta el chocolate, right? But if you want to say the chocolates, los chocolates, then that becomes a plural noun and you have to say me gustan los chocolates. So with this expression, it's quite similar in that sense. So we say me da miedo, right? And then you put something singular. Me da miedo el matrimonio, por ejemplo. We have a bride in here. Woo! So if you're scared of compromising and you want to say, I'm actually scared of marriage, you can say, me da miedo el matrimonio. But if you're going to say something plural, like we were saying before with
las
me,
arañas,
or... exactly, with Brenda's fear, which is las arañas, the spiders, or the heights, las alturas, so you have to say, me dan miedo las arañas. Me dan miedo las alturas. So you just have to put an N at the end of da, dan. Okay, so you make it plural. Yes? So another thing is that if you are using a verb, all right, like you were saying before, viajar, to travel, or
volar.
Manejar, sí, volar, to fly. Manejar, which means to drive, or conducir, to drive as well. So in that case, you have to keep it singular as well. Me da miedo volar. Okay.
And remember, in español, we're going to use el verbo en infinitivo. So volar, conducir, manejar. In English, we're going to use the ing form.
Exactly.
Okay?
I'm scared of flying. Well, in Spanish, you just need the infinitive verb. So it's pretty easy. You can just look up any verb that sort of
scares you.
Yeah.
Que te da miedo.
You're afraid of on the dictionary, and that's it. You just have to complete the form, the expression with that verb at the end.
Okay. And so the question, what would be the question with this particular expression?
Mm-hmm. Que te da miedo. ¿Qué te da miedo? So, on the comments below, please leave us a comment with both expressions, okay? So, if you're scared, like myself, to heights, I want you to say both expressions on your comment, okay? So, tengo miedo a las alturas and me dan miedo las alturas, okay? And be honest, we really would love to know what you're actually scared of.
Muy bien. Y feliz noche de brujas para todos.
Feliz noche de brujas. Adiós.
Adiós.
Adiós. If you are new to our YouTube channel, be sure to subscribe to get notifications so you don't miss our video lessons. You can also follow us on Facebook or Instagram. And if you want to learn some basic phrases right now, you can sign up to our free weekly Spanish lessons. I'll leave you guys the link in the description.